So good afternoon, class. Today the name of the topic is troubleshooting hard drive problems. Means what type of hard drive problems we have and how can we overcome all these problems. Next we will study what is device drivers, what is the meaning of device drivers, what is the role of device drivers, and what are the various types of device drivers we have. So first we need to know what is hard drive. So hard drive means hard disk drive or hard drive. It's just a drive that you use to store the data. We can store the data in a hard disk drive or a hard drive so that the data you are storing in a hard drive should be permanent. So if the power is shut off and when the system is shut down, the files remain static. So we have some problems that we have to face regarding the hard drive. The first is viruses and malware. We know that if we are working with a technology and we are working with a computer system, there will be a chances of viruses and attacks. So there will be a chances that the hard drive we've got affected with the entry of the viruses and malwares. Next, we have hardware failures. It means sometimes the situations arises when we have the failures of hardware.
Recording in progress.
In that case, hardware failure means there will be a chances that defective hardware sold by the manufacturer or it got failed when we are using such hardware. So there is a one chances of hardware failure. The next we have corrupted or outdated drivers. As we know that we have a device drivers, there will be a chances that they got corrupted or outdated. If you feel that your drivers are corrupted and outdated, you can go for a new one. Either you can install. And if they are outdated, you can update it later on. Next, we have a problem of overheating. Problem of overheating arises when we are using the computer for a long time. Let us suppose that we are using the computer 24 hours. In that case, there will be a chances that computer got overheated. To overcome this problem, make it sure that you have a good cooling capacity, good CPU cooling, and you have good fans. And if you think that fan should be repaired and replaced, then go for this very soon. Now, troubleshooting hard drive problems. Now see, if any problem arises like problem of overheating, problem of outdated drivers, hardware failures, viruses and other malware arises, then how can we overcome these problems? How can we troubleshoot these problems? So now we are going to discuss step by step how can we troubleshoot the hard drive problems. Step one is stop using your computer immediately. If you feel that there is a hard drive problem, then stop using your computer immediately. Go to the power button, click on the shut button immediately. So stop using your computer immediately. Go to power, then go to shutdown. Next. Try plugging your hard drive into a different port or computer. Eject your pen drive or hard drive, then try to plug in or try to insert into some other port of the computer. Know the different components of hard drive. It's very important to know the different components of the hard drive. Like this is the spindle, this is the read-write head, this is the disk, and this is known as arm. This is the circuit board, this is the front, this is the saved file, this is the actuator. So these are the various components of hard drive. You must know all the components. Next we have PCB, platers, head assembly. So PCB means it is the circuit board that is on the bottom of your hard drive, at the end of your hard drive, that control the hard drive functions. And it's also converting or translating the hard drive information into readable information. So circuit boards are typically green. They are mostly in a green color. So this is the one of the circuit board that control the working of the hard drives, and basically it translates the hard drive information into readable information. So basically they are in of color green. Next we have a platers, thin disk, small disk, thin disk that are used to store the data. Basically platers are responsible for most of the noise you hear when your hard drive starts up. So they are responsible when we start up the hard drive, we listen some noise. The reason of this noise is only the platers. So when we start the hard drive, we are listening some voice, and this voice is only due to platers. Uh, And unless you are a professional with access to clean rooms and the necessary equipment, you will not be able to fix your hard drive later on your own. So if you are not handy with all these gadgets, then you are not able to solve this problem at your site. Next is head assembly. The head assembly is what reads the data off of the platter. It means head assembly basically read the data that we are storing in our platters. And platters are what? They are a disk on which we are storing the data. Again, if you don't have a good experience with all the gadgets, you are not able to repair the problem if you face. Next step is assess the sound your drive was making. Try to listen the sound, and this sound is only when we start up the hard drives, the sound arises due to platters. Step 5, refrain from using do-it-yourself quick fixes. So try to do some actions at your side if you know and if you have a little experience. Now we have 5 ways to troubleshoot hard disk. We have 5 ways to troubleshoot hard disk. The way 1 and the step 1 is restart your PC. Go to power button, go to start, go to power button, click on the restart. This is the step 1 or way 1. Way 2, check the cable and USB ports. Try to check the cable and USB port to overcome this problem. Step 3, check the disk for the errors. Now it's time to check the disk for the errors. Method 1, run in a file explorer. Now check the disk for error is again divided into methods. So first method is run in file explorer. Open the file explorer and find out the disk which are creating the problem. Right click on the hard disk with errors. It means the hard disk which is creating the problem, right click on it. Now go to the properties. Navigate to tools bar in the properties window, then click on the check button. Now select scan and repair drive to start detecting and fixing disk errors. So first phase, if we are going to check the disk for the errors, if you want to check the disk to identify the error, you have one method that is run in the file explorer. This is the method 1. Open the file explorer, then select the hard disk that is creating the problem, right click on the hard disk. Then choose the properties, and in properties window, you have a toolbar, click on it. In toolbar, click on the check button, then click on the scan and repair drive so that we can detect and fix the disk errors. See, go to, first of all, go to File Explorer, then hard disk, then go to property. In property, go to tools, and in tools go to check button, then in tools, from tools what we are clicking, check, from check click on the scan and repair drive. So now it's scanning drive and it will repair if it will feel any type of error. Method one was to run in a file explorer. Method two, check disk in a command prompt. Now we are going to check the disk in a command prompt, means we are going to check the disk in a MS-DOS. Type CMD in the search box on the taskbar, and we all know that on a taskbar we have a search box. In a search box, type CMD. Right click on the command prompt. We will get the CMD. Then click right click on this. Then select run as administrator. Then type this coding, type chkdsk check disk, then /F and press enter, wait for the completion. So see, first we will go to the taskbar. On taskbar, right type the command cmd and press enter. You will get this black screen, and in this black screen you need to type check disk /H:// F. So this type of file system is NTFS. This is regarding networking. Way 4 is to run antivirus program. This is another issue we have studied in a slide 1. Viruses and other malware, they are creating the problems for hard drives. So your task is to run antivirus program. As we have studied in a practical class, I will show you how can we install and run the antivirus? You can go to any antivirus to protect your data from being stolen. Way five, that is the last way, check the network issues. Maybe there will be a chances of network issues. That's why we are getting the problem regarding the hard drives. So how can we fix these type of problems? Try to unplug the routers. Maybe there will be a chances of problem due to the routers. So unplug the routers, cables, DSL modems from your device. First you need to unplug it. Then later on you can plug it again. Unplug means you just need to swap it out from the plug. Wait for 30 to 60 seconds. We have to wait for this. Then plug again them into the device. So first we need to unplug, then later on wait for 30 to 60 seconds, again plug it back. The next term that we have, and this is the new topic, device drivers. We will study what is device drivers, what is the meaning of device driver, role of device driver. As we know that device driver means, it's completely clear from the name, device driver. It means we need some drivers to run the device, as we need drivers to run the bus, as we need drivers to run the car, as we need drivers to run the bicycle, motorcycles. In the same way, we need drivers to run the devices. If we want the devices to be do their work in efficient manner, what we need some drivers. If I want to type from the keyboard, I need drivers for the keyboard. I want to listen something, I want to use speaker, I need to install the speaker drivers. It means for every associated device, you may have a drivers. So device driver is a in computing refers to the special kind of software programs or a specified type of software applications which control a hardware device that enable different hardware devices for communication with computers operating system. Basically, as in a real life, we need drivers to run the car, bicycle. In the same way, in a computer technology, we need drivers to execute or to run the devices. A device driver communicates with the computer hardware by computer subsystem or computer bus connected to hardware. Basically, a device driver is one of the special software program that is used to establish the communication with the different hardware devices and operating system. Device drivers are very useful, necessary and essential for computer system so that they can work properly, because without a device driver, the particular hardware fails to work. So it means if you want your hardware components to be work in a very good manner or to work in a proper way, we need to install the driver first of the device that we want to use. In very common way, most term it only as a drivers. So it is also known as a device drivers, simple drivers or a hardware drivers. This is application bidirectional. It is communicating with the user driver. Then we have a device driver. Then this is divided into two modes. One is user mode and second is kernel mode. We will study in the coming slides user mode drivers, kernel mode drivers. So as we see, application is bidirectionally interacting with the user drivers and device drivers. Now see the working of device drivers. Device driver is completely depend upon the operating system instructions to access the device and performing any particular action. So what action to be performed, what work to be done, it's completely depend upon the operating system instruction. What type of instructions generated by operating system depend upon operating system instructions the device driver have to perform the work. After the action, they also show their reaction by delivering output or status message from hardware device to operating system. For example, printer driver tells the printer in which format to print after it getting the instruction from operating system. Let us suppose that when we are printing, then in a properties we have to set, I want to print one-sided, I want to print on a both-sided, I want to print all the pages, I want to print only the current page, and I want to print the selection area. So we have a lots of options. So what type of instruction I'm giving to the operating system depend upon the instruction of operating system the device driver will work on. Let us suppose that I select print on both side. It means then operating system sends, I'm selecting what print on both side, then it will tell the device driver that they are getting the instructions to print on both sides. User, applications, operating system, device drivers, then we have a device. First, we have a device that we are using. Let us suppose it may be a keyboard, it may be a mouse, printer, scanner, speakers, and this device has a device driver. This device driver interacting with an operating system. Operating system has various applications, and applications have users. Means users are using the applications. This is the hardware, and this is the software. So first we have a device, and for corresponding this device, we have a device drivers, and then we have operating system, and we know that application user. So this is the diagram of device driver. Next is types of device driver. How many types of device driver we have? We have basically two types drivers: kernel mode device drivers, user mode device drivers. Now, first is kernel mode device drivers. This kernel mode device driver includes some hardwares which load with the operating system as the part of operating system. These are BIOS. Let us suppose that when we switch on the computer system, we know that when we see one blue progress bar is moving on, it means the operating system is loaded. But when the operating system is loaded, most of the other components are also getting start up with the loading of operating system. These are BIOS, basic input output, motherboard, processors, and some other hardwares that are the part of kernel. That's why they are called kernel mode device drivers. So these include the minimum system requirement device driver for each operating system. When we switch on the computer, we have to wait until and unless we get the welcome screen of the computer system. So when the operating system is loading, it means some other components also loading with it. And these are BIOS, motherboard, processors, and some other hardware. Next category, user mode device drivers. Other than the devices which are brought by kernel for working of the system, the user also brings some devices for use during the using of the system. So user mode means that is completely depend upon the user requirement. For example, user need any plug and play action that come under this. If I want to use the printer, I just need to plug it in. And if I don't want to use the printer, I just need to plug it out. So user mode means that is completely depend upon the user. Kernel mode means that is dependent or that is associated with operating system. Operating system is kernel, and kernel is the heart. Next is the purpose of device drivers. What is the benefit and uses and purpose of device driver? It operate and control the device that we are connecting to the computer. Means what type of device I'm connecting to the computer, that device is completely operated and controlled by device drivers. It provide an interface between operating system and devices. Basically, it act as an interface. It act as an intermediate between devices and operating system. It tells the operating system how to communicate with hardware components. So as it act as an interface between operating system and device, and it also tells the operating system how to communicate with hardware components. It translates the request between device and computer. So it also works as a translator. Next, we have architecture of device drivers. It is divided into two-layer architecture, logical layer and physical layer. So we have a logical layer, and basically logical layer is for it processes the data for class of devices. So logical layer is what? Logical layer process data for a class of devices. It means it start or it execute, it process the data for what? For class of devices. Next we have a physical layer. Physical layer communicate with specific device objects. So basically logical layer is what? It begins with the category of devices, means class of device. Means we have a two classes, input class devices and output class devices. So it process the data for class of device. You want to execute the data for input classes or output classes. Next, we have a physical layer. Basically, physical layer is that deals and communicate with device instance, means device objects. Every device driver consists of two important data structures. So every device driver follow two type of data structure. The one is device information structure and the second is static structure. So one is device information and second is static structure. So first is device information structure. It is of static files, means they are fixed, not changeable, which is passed to the install entry point, and its functionality is to pass along any information required to install a major device into the install entry point, where it get going to be used to initialize the static structure. Basically, device information structure means, as you have studied in data structure, structures means the logic, mathematical and logical organization of specific particular organization of data is called a data structure. So device information structure means we have to define some framework, we have to define some structure pattern where we can store the information regarding the device. Next we have a static structure. Static means it is the fixed in a nature, it is not changeable. So it is used to pass the information between different entry points and it is initialized with the information stored in the information structure. So basically it passes information between various entry points, means starting points, and it initializes the information that is stored in the information centers. So structure. So we have a two types of data structure. One is device information structure, means it is the structure where we have to store the information regarding the devices. Next, we have a static structure, means we have to store the fixed information in it. In this, we have a different entry points and we have to initialize these entry points with the information that are stored in information structure. Next, we have other types of drivers include, we have a instead of kernel mode drivers or user mode drivers, we have a character drivers, we have a block drivers, next we have a generic and OEM drivers, and we have a virtual drivers. So instead of having a kernel mode driver is completely connected and associated with operating system, and whereas user mode drivers basically that type of drivers means that you can plug and play. Next is character drivers. These drivers are used as a serial bus. They write a data one character at a time. They behave like a serial bus. It means they are used to write down the data one character at a time. So if the device is connected to the computer system via serial port, they are characterized as being a character drivers. So basically, if character drivers are associated with the serial buses, they are writing the character one character at a time. So if any device that is connected with the computer via serial port, then we can be recognized it as a character devices. For example, keyboard or mouse. Next, we have a block drivers. Basically, these are the drivers that refer to writing and reading of more than one character at a time. Character driver means we just only write the data. Reading is not possible. We only write the data and only one character at a time. But in case of block means collection of more than one characters. We can either write the data, read the data, but more than one character at a time. So these drivers are creating the blocks and we can retrieve the information also in the form of blocks. Next, we have a generic and OEM. OEM stands for original equipment manufacturer drivers. So generic device drivers can be generic or even OEM related. Both, if the device driver come with its own operating system, then they can be categorized as a being generic. Generic means they are unique one. So if they have their own operating system, they are become under the category of generic. Basically, they can be utilized with a number of different brands. So we have a different types of generic drivers depend upon the brand. For instance, Windows 10 works with number of generic drivers that function without having the need to install any other software manually. So every operating system have different functionality. Whereas OEM create their own device drivers. So they are the manufacturer. They can design their own device drivers. So these drivers should be installed separately after installing the operating system. They are not with the operating system. Basically, generic drivers are those, they have their own operating system. If we are installing the driver, it means we are installing the operating system also. But in case of OEM, if we are installing the drivers, we need to install the operating system separately. So operating system and device drivers both are not installed at the same time. But in case of generic, we can install drivers and operating system combined. The next category of drivers we have, that is called virtual drivers. These type of drivers refer to the software that is used to emulate hardware and other devices so that multiple applications running in protected mode can have access hardware interrupt channels. So hardware resources, memory without causing conflict. So virtual drivers means, as we have already discussed, virtual means that are existing but not visible. So such drivers are those drivers that is not visible but still they exist. We can use it. So thank you so much, class. So that was all about what is hard disk drive, what are the various problems that we have to face, like viruses, like not updated drivers, like we have a problem with hardware failures. Sometime we have some another problems like outdated drivers. So we have studied what is device, then what is device drivers, what are the various types, purpose, how can we troubleshoot the hard drive problems if we feel any type of problem, if we have to face any type of problem related to hard drive, how can we troubleshoot all these problems. So today, that was all about today class. Thank you so much.